ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining TGIF show tonight. We have a discussion today with the following gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining us. Maybe you can introduce yourself before we start our show tonight. Let's start from this end.
Well, I'm Stuart. Stuart. Stuart is a commissar at the MDM.
I'm a student, Herman Moses, a political science student.
Thank you.
I'm Hagai Kongo, a commissar of MDM.
Thank you so much for joining us today. My name is Emmanuel Barak and I am your host. As we start it off, maybe let us know what is MDF, maybe in full, Stuart.
Well, MDF is a movement for advanced democracy, and MDF is a revolutionary group that is ideologically based. It is a movement that is for the liberals. It's a movement for those who want change.
Yes.
It's a movement for those who want a better Kenya. And it's a movement for anyone that feels want to fight injustice.
Yes.
Anyone who want to fight impunity. Anyone who want to make this country better than it is now.
Okay, again, what's your take about MDF?
Like what MDF, just to echo his words,
yes,
is a group which is championing for social justice and as a moral responsibility for any Kenyan citizen. We need to demand for justice.
Yes.
We cannot demand justice while you beg.
Yes.
That is why we call this a revolutionary group, so we are going to demand justice. Because as of now, we are not satisfied with the state of affairs.
Okay, I'm a process. Do you think, thank you so much, Hagai. Do you think MDF is a solution to the end of justice in Kenya?
Well, I cannot speak about it. If you permit me, I cannot speak about the solution. But I can't speak about the means.
Yes.
I would first of all say that a revolutionary, as far as our political system is based today and our current affairs, a revolutionary is required to make things right.
Yeah.
So I would just say that the MDF, as we currently know it, just as one of the several means. The only question that we need to find out or to inquire is whether is it the right means? Is it does it have the ability to make things right now?
Stuart, why MDF? Why do you think MDF is the solution?
Well, it does not necessarily mean it should be MDF.
Yes.
But it should be based on ideas. We want to come up with a setup. We want to come up with a group, a community in which every Kenyan feel belong to. We want to fight for the oppressed and fight the oppressors.
Okay, again, maybe we can talk about the framework of MDF. Why, what are you going to do and what's your plan?
Okay, well, one thing I believe with us in MDF is that it is not all about us.
Yes.
It is about the people. And because we identify with the people, we have chosen to represent their views.
Yes.
Because right now, the political setup in this country,
yes,
the system is aligned to a way that it does not speak on behalf of the issues of affecting the current moment.
Yeah.
If you see, all the parliamentarians are either like one political party or the other. And party politics is what has kept this country on the dark side of history, where there are cases of corruption, which are rampant, social injustices. And we keep promoting these party politics by being allied to certain politicians.
Yes.
We don't want that position as MDF. So
okay,
our position is that we want to bring all the issues together. We engage in this national dialogue. As we move forward, we address this issue.
Yeah.
Even if it means having our own representing us in parliament.
Yeah.
But really, for those who might be
in
that position,
yes,
we'll be very happy to serve as those people champion for the interest of them.
Okay, thank you so much. Herman Moses, back to you. Let's talk about the ASIC framework, MDF. Now, they're saying that they want to stop the party concentration among the youths. Do you think it's going to be appropriate and why do you think so?
First of all, we need to admit that our politics is based on party politics.
Yes.
And even right now, the fact that we are coming with the MDF revolution, MDF after the revolution, within the revolution, is in itself a political path. So now, which you cannot, of course, try to say that the revolution will not convert MDF to to our political party. You had several groups that came out to be just coalition, but after the election they converted themselves to political parties, and therefore I do not believe that MDF is a different thing.
Okay. What do you think of that, Stuart?
Well, I like to say that man is by nature political animal.
Yes.
And sorry, we cannot avoid the politics in human beings.
Yeah.
So one, as much as this organization is going to be political, which I don't believe, it is based on ideas.
Yeah.
We are insisting that MDF is a leadership group that is based on ideologies. We are not going to discuss about people. We are not going to talk about people. And again, what I want to just respond to what Herman said.
Yes.
Well, it is time. This is the time that we have to stand up and fight for society.
Yeah.
And our main tools that we are going to fight with is our brains. We have the brains. We have the hands. We have the legs. We have the voices. And most important thing is the unity that is bestowed upon us.
Okay.
So if we come together, unite, get a common goal, and fight for what we belong, for what we really want, then you are going to achieve it.
Okay, back to you, Agari. The open statement, the social media, of course, on the platform where the MDF currently is concentrating on Facebook page, in the open statement that someone said that youth should learn to think and act as a mass. It is criminal to think as an individual. What do you think about that?
It is criminal to think as an individual.
Yes.
Okay. For as long as what you are thinking about is to serve the interest of the majority, I think it is true. Because when I joined MDF, I joined MDF because I saw this as a group which is has interest. Because I have interest in partners. I also joined this group because they are discussing mainly on the issues which are affecting us on day to day basis.
Yes.
And first, I want to correct my friend, that MDM is not a political party. Because there are people there who are members.
Yeah.
It's not like we are not going to register it as a political party.
Yeah.
As of now, it is not registered as a political party.
Yes, it's not a political party.
And I can give you examples. Yeah. There are many examples. Like Julius Malema as a group, EFF in South Africa.
Yes.
When was first EFF? When was this EFF? It has been some years, but they have been supporting what?
Yeah.
They have been championing for the rights of people of South Africa, even though they were not in parliament. They were not elected under a political party as MDF. Go come back to our neighbor country here, Uganda.
Yes.
Bobi Wine has been championing for rights with this movement, People Power. But he has no party registered as People Power.
Yeah.
In fact, the other day he was endorsing an independent candidate.
Yes.
Against the Museveni endorsed candidate.
Yes.
Which he won. That is the reason why he was accused by the government of treason. So MDF is not a political party.
How many of
the people who are who want to serve this government?
Okay. How about Moses talk about his reaction on that?
Well, you know, what we need to understand is that let us use our own history to define our own self.
Yes.
Now, I'm very glad that he's quoted South African Affairs.
Yes.
Yes.
And
of course, as we speak right now, Julius Malema is a party. Okay? It began as a revolution.
Yes.
But now it is a party.
It is a party. Why?
Now, when, of course, you know, after the revolution has gone through the testing of politics,
yes,
the people of the same mind simply convert themselves to be a political
party. Okay, so you believe all this is political?
Very political.
Okay, so, Stuart, talk about that.
Well, our main duty as a liberal person or someone who wants to fight is to press on and not to let the oppressors rest.
Yes.
And our core values are based on the forefathers. Our forefathers who fought for this struggle. We had the history, those who had the lovers of history.
Yeah.
We have how Martin Luther King fought for the racial discrimination in the US. We have people like Mahatma Gandhi, the Indian Revolution. And we don't need to fight. We don't need to use bullets to fight for what we really want. I mean, this
there's different methods, including civil disobedience.
Yes.
A way that people can really listen to us.
Yes.
We want the government to recognize us and listen to us.
Okay. Okay. Thank you so much, Stuart, for that. We're coming back to you, guys. Talking about the politics that have been ongoing in the country, we have been focusing on the parties and that is a bit the trend of the nation. Don't you think parties have done much as it is now your enemies speak?
Okay, my opinion about parties is that they have failed us.
Yes, so far. In what way?
Because they represent the interest of individuals.
Yes.
You see, someone is elected under the party, for example, when Jubilee reduces 8% tax to tax money for development, which is not right, according to my concerns, I can condemn it. But you see, someone who is a parliamentarian elected under the ticket of Jubilee, has to speak the ideologies of the party, to speak the ideologies that they are going to tax money.
Yeah.
If they condemn it, then there are someone to answer, and they are threatened.
Yeah.
Their position is threatened as a leader.
Yes.
So that is what we don't want in this country. And it is not criminal to have MDF as a political party in future. If it grows to that extent that it is popular in all countries, then it can be registered later as a political party. So that it unites.
And that was what Aban was saying, that it will be a political party.
Yes, at that point it will be uniting all the people who want to fight for the interests of the community.
Okay. Aban was
saying, you know, when I started saying that, I told you that the means of a revolution, we now have gotten in MDF, will justify the end of the MDF.
Yes.
Now, the end of MDF, you might say that, of course, after it has become popular, it simply converts itself
into a political party.
Into a political party.
Yes.
Now, what we need to know is that MDF is rooted among the youths.
Yes.
Now, we need to understand is that what kind of youths are we talking about?
Yeah.
You know, in our country today, we have different kind of youths. Are we talking about the elite youth?
Yes.
Or are we talking about the poor youth who is taken to the wrong school, taken to the wrong university, taken to the wrong course and poured into the streets to admire the wealth of the elite? Are we talking about that youth?
Uh-huh.
So the moment our understanding of the MDF is realized upon these two kinds of youth, that's when you can understand what MDF really wants.
Yeah.
But you know, currently, because MDF is, I would simply describe it as a hot air, because it is found in the rumors of social media.
Yeah.
It's found on the ground, it is not there completely.
Yes, uh-huh.
So because it is completely.
We are not interested in being a political organization anymore.
Yes.
This is a group that is representing the people. Whatever means that you're going to represent the people should be based on ideas and fighting for the people. Well, we cannot say that MDF can avoid politics. We have EFF in South Africa.
Yeah.
They have their representative, but they have an EFF party. They're still fighting in parliament and they fought until they ensure that Zuma is out. Because Zuma was one of the people encouraging impunity, looted everything, and South Africa went dry, made South Africa to the legs.
Yes.
So we are not going to accept that. Mm. The EFF party fought and ensured that Zuma was kicked out.
Yes.
Another case, Bobi Wine.
Yeah.
Is one of our inspirations, of course.
Yeah.
Bobi Wine is now fighting.
Mm-hmm.
And it's only when Museveni will hit the pressure that Bobi Wine will relax.
Mm.
So revolutionaries do not tire fighting.
Yeah.
And our ideology is based on fighting for the people, and not fighting for the individuals.
Okay.
And while we also condemn the issues of political parties, right now the main political parties are Jubilee, or we have NASA. Who do they represent? They represent no idea.
Okay, that's not according to you.
No, but that's what I know. Anyone who knows that.
Okay.
They represent no idea.
Mm-hmm.
They don't represent the people.
Yeah.
They give their leaders give them directions to follow.
Yeah.
Should we take directions from the people from our leaders?
So are you still let me interrupt. You're going to make it that people just are there to give up the ideas. How should you do that?
Well, let me tell you one thing.
Mm-hmm.
Ask any Kenyan now.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone is tired.
Yeah.
The high prices of living, high rate of corruption.
Yeah.
The other day, the Senate had a public meeting, Baraza.
Yeah.
It was in Gishu.
Uh-huh.
No one is happy. Though the region is being represented by the deputy president.
Yes.
No one is happy.
Mm-hmm.
Farmers are not getting paid.
Yeah.
So something must change, and it must change right now.
The guy, what's your statement on that?
Okay, about to respond to my friend here.
Yeah.
He said that this is just like a political party. No, when I said that. Later when MDF has taken root, it should even register as a political party. That was my opinion.
Yeah.
Because as far as I understand, we are yet to launch MDF officially.
Yes.
So there are some of the objectives you have not defined as far as MDF is concerned.
Yeah.
So, but for now, we are still championing for the issues which are affecting the people, the
whole
man. Mr. Stewart, I said there.
Yeah.
The other day, those senators who are in Rosicrucian County for their meeting, they were asked to talk mains. None of them were willing to speak.
Mm.
And back then, because that is where I was born,
Our
parents have not been paid, left it to them.
Yes.
So they have still, the government still owes them money. Because this money was paid to people who are cartels, who did not supply anything.
Yes.
That is the problem. These are some of the issues we have there.
Thank you so much, Agai. Back to you, Raman Moses.
First, I want to make myself very clear that it is not a political suicide to convert MDF into a political party.
Yes.
And just to base ourselves on what we have the current affairs, everything good in the political scene in Kenya has been achieved by political parties.
Mm.
Now, the KANU itself was a political party that got us independence.
Right.
Again, it was not a coalition and later party that could remove the dictatorial KANU from government. Again, later on, we had the Jubilee Coalition,
and
later on changed to a political party.
Mm.
There is no problem to have MDF as a political party.
Yes.
But what I need you to understand is that what is the intention of MDF?
Yes.
Because, you know, we cannot just be sitting here and told that, okay, fine, we have a revolutionary which is devoid in principle, a revolutionary which is devoid in goals, a revolutionary which has no future.
Yeah.
And, you know. What we need to understand also forthwith is that the MDF revolution, as we call it, right now, is just like we are told, it's youth-based.
Yes.
Okay?
No, let me correct my friend.
Yes.
MDF is not youth-based. MDF is built on ideologies, and anyone who subscribes to our ideologies is a member of MDF.
How many people are there that are not youth?
Well, MDF, as you call it, Movement for Advanced
Democracy,
anyone who believes in it is a member.
But can we talk about the current situation right now? Are the youths and the people subscribing to this MDF?
Most of them.
Yes.
Why? Not all of them.
Yeah.
Most of them. Mm-hmm. Because youths are the most affected individuals. Right?
Let me
just finish my point. The reason why we have a group of youths fighting for this. We don't expect the old to come in because one, the old does not have the power now to talk, to shout out for what they want.
Mm.
They'll be supporting us.
Mm.
But when we take this ideology and sell out and say, look, this is what you want to do.
Yeah.
Everywhere, top revolutionists are not old people.
Okay.
They are young people who grew up, fight for something.
Okay.
Bobi Wine is not old.
He's not old.
Malema is not old.
Okay.
When a revolution was started in Cuba by Che Guevara, and very many people.
Yeah.
They're not old people, so, but a lot of things is not an old person.
Okay, yeah. So imagine how much was the
you know, the underlying, because you've spoken of ideology.
Yes.
The underlying ideology for MDM is advanced democracy.
Yes.
Right? Mm. Meaning that we are already an existing kind of democracy, but now want to advance it.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, we need to ask the MDM,
yes.
What is democracy to them?
Mm.
Okay?
Answer that, my brother. What's democracy to MDM?
Ruled by the people.
Does it exist?
Yeah. In MDF.
Currently, yes. Yeah.
In Kenya,
yeah,
it does not exist.
It doesn't exist
because it is not by the people.
Do you believe so?
When you say democracy is ruled by the people for the people.
Yes,
meaning that it is the people ruling for themselves.
Yes,
right.
Do you believe masses can rule the entire nation?
Well, I think when we look at the ideology of democracy, picking from its definition, of course, that's Abraham Lincoln's definition of democracy.
Mm.
That's just the purest.
Yeah.
Now we need to note this. There's the purest democracy, but it's the most impossible democracy.
Yes.
Democracy has never been achieved. In fact, the United States once almost reached the climax of democracy, but they never achieved it.
Yes.
And you know, democracy in Africa and in Kenya in particular is an alien ideology.
Mm.
It does not work in Africa.
Yeah.
And that's why you find out that when the West went and told Libyans that, okay, we want to bring for you democracy, and they ousted Muammar Gaddafi, Libya today is gone to the dogs.
Mm-hmm.
When they went to Egypt, let me just finish.
Mm-hmm.
When they went to Egypt and they ousted the president there, Egypt today has gone to the dogs.
Yes.
So when we are talking of democracy, we need to define our democracy in our own Kenyan context.
Yes.
Because right now, with the current revolution referendum movement that is going around the country,
we are
still talking about the same democracy.
Democracy.
So the apex of referendum today is still that democracy. And we are saying, okay, fine, because the presidential system has refused to work, let us introduce another tire system.
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So the advanced democracy which MDF seeks to reintroduce must be well with the common man.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
It must not be something borrowed from Julius Malema in South Africa. It must not be something borrowed from Uganda, from Bobby Wine.
Yeah.
But it must be Kenya system.
It must be unique in that
sovereignty.
Sure, I'm thinking of something.
You know the problem with my friend Hammer is he's appreciating what we really start.
Yeah.
You see, we cannot say that you can't learn from other people. Africa has the same type of democracy.
Yes.
And there is something we really need to change about it.
Mm.
We have very many countries that deserve to be better, and they're not better.
Yeah.
Well, I find it very logical for my friend to talk about the West and Africa at the same time.
Mm.
The West has ruined Africa.
Yeah.
That's right.
They're not for any better for
them.
So when we talk about Africa, we want to talk about what do Africa really stand for.
Mm-hmm.
We are not going to talk about the West and Africa. Because what we have observed from the West is that they have done us more harm than advantage.
Yeah.
So the democracy in Kenya is not that much different from the democracy that was fought by the forefathers of revolutionists.
Okay.
You cannot say that the democracy that Malema is fighting in South Africa is different from the democracy we are fighting
in Kenya.
Just a common goal.
Okay, Aman, it was very clear on Aman's statement. He was trying to say that maybe we can consider the field where we want to bring MDF. That is Kenya, of course. So, have we really considered the factors that we have currently? Like you spoke about the referendum, of course, that is ongoing in the country.
Absolutely.
Now, to help the same democracy that is not existing, that's what you say there.
Yes.
So, his point of concern is that do you think the MDF is really going to really match with the current situation in Kenya, and also to create another opportunity to make this democracy not a point or another story, but something that is achievable?
Mr.
Jamal,
yes. In the fullness of time, Kenyans will realize that we need to speak about issues which are affecting us and avoid this issue of party politics.
Yeah.
And as I said before, this thing is not about us.
Yeah.
You said that MDF does not have a national army. It has a national army.
Mm.
Because as I speak, I come from Wazigishu County, he comes from the good.
Yeah.
He did not take me to MDF, neither did I take him. But we found ourselves in MDF because we have this interest in a leadership
yeah.
and the ideologies which are anchored by MDF.
MDF.
So literally MDF is representing all these.
Okay. Now back to the open statement that you gave on the social media platform by Mohammed Kedar Ibrahim. Let me quote. He said that the MDF does not have a clear roadmap to liberate the country apart from the slogans and the raising. This would say maybe a link to our quote statement. And again, you say that he does not tolerate criticism and free speech. Is that true about the
MDF? Well, everyone is entitled to his own opinion.
Yes.
And we can't compare them.
Yes.
But because MDF is an Indonesian group, mm-hmm. our foundation is truly based on democracy.
Yes.
I'll give you an example. Mm-hmm. The founder yeah. of this group, or someone who came with his opinion, is Commissar Dege Frederick.
Yes.
And Dege Frederick came up with a list, mm-hmm. proposed list, an interim officials mm-hmm. for that purpose, that will run the MDF affairs.
Okay.
But then it was not satisfactory to most of the people. Mm-hmm. And then we sat down and said, well, if this is not satisfactory, and our MDF are built on the foundation of democracy, then let us reject that list.
Yes.
And you are going to need to sign it with your agreement
yes.
for everyone to speak what they want.
Okay. Thank you so much.
To add on that, uh-huh. it is not to question the roadmap of the MDF.
Yeah.
They are not launching.
You're not launching.
So the question on there was no freedom of, there was intimidation on uh-huh. the part of the past uh-huh. for speaking out mm. their feelings about MDF. Mm. I think there was a controversy over the issue of the list.
The list of the leadership.
But the chairman himself mm.
yeah.
Declared the list now because mm. we all believe in democracy.
Yeah.
You are,
so you generally you accept critiques and you also accept
yes, we want to be, yeah, yeah. we want to include all yeah. in part of this discussion.
Yes,
allow me to back. You know, Kenyans and particularly the youth need to be very afraid. If the MDF, the idea of MDF is was coined by you say it was coined by one negative. And you know history never forgets. That these are the same Kenyans, including the Republic, who supported Babu Owino's dictatorial term in University of Nairobi.
Uh-huh.
You remember, Babu Owino was someone who was untouchable. Any opponents who came to him was an outright enemy. I think some of the students have suffered in the UN simply because of that.
Yeah.
So, you know, when you see someone like Babu Owino hanging out with one Bobby Wine, mm-hmm. and they tell you that we are of the same ideology, you need to be very afraid.
Yes.
Because you need to be very afraid.
Yeah.
The same Babu Owino, which now I know obviously will come and say we are the sponsors or we are the donors of MDF, obviously that will happen. The same, let me just be done.
That is very inaccurate.
Let me just be done.
I think that is a very inaccurate statement.
Yes.
We say that in MDF you don't discuss people.
Yeah.
And you don't discuss those that are in relations with the oppressors.
Yes.
MDF is purely for the oppressed, mm-hmm. it's for the people.
Yeah.
And when you say that Dege was a close person to Babu Owino, mm-hmm. that is then.
Yes.
But now what do we stand for?
Mm-hmm.
Right now, what do we stand for?
Mm-hmm.
You identify a problem. There's a problem in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
Kenya is at a mess. Mm-hmm. No one is listening to the oppressed.
Yes.
So we are tied with the ideologies. We are not tied about the history of the people.
Okay. Mm.
What we are fighting now is what is affecting Kenyans.
Okay.
As in MDF,
yes,
we believe in championing for justice.
Yes.
And we want to start where the country is,
yes.
so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
We have given an example of one Babu Owino,
yes.
who is not a member of MDF.
Who is not a
member of MDF,
yes.
as far as I'm concerned.
Why do you think so?
Because he's dealing with the oppressor. We all know the who is the oppressor in this country. So, in MDF, it was right for you to also tell us that recently, Dege said, come, tender this resignation letter to the Bakassi constituency, to the office of Babu Owino, because of his recent traits, what he has done in politics, the people he has been supporting. He has been fighting what he literally believed in, justice to even the youth, because most of the people who are affected in this country, most of the people who vote in this country, most of the people who are used, even by politicians, are the youth.
Okay.
Most of the people who face the issues of unemployment are the youth. So any
issue which is affecting the youth, we must address it.
Okay, I'm going to ask you a little break.
Well, it is right, it is very right that someone can change.
Yeah.
For one, electorate who is now most of the has become a pilgrim of change. He can change. You know, he condoned with Babu Owino for like 3-5 years of such time. And of course, you can remember that, you know, the problem we are having in country, in our country today are politicians who camouflage, you know, they camouflage into different identities.
Yes.
The same guys that fought KANU in NAC 202 mm-hmm. are the same members of KANU in 1998.
Yes.
Okay? So you know, they just camouflage.
Mm-hmm.
The same members of NAC mm-hmm. are the same people who fought against PNU in 207. The same people who fought PNU in 2007 and the same people who formed CORD and formed Jubilee. Now, when you look at that list of individuals, it tells you one thing, that Kenyans in general are champions of political camouflage.
Yes.
They change with the time. So, you know, I want to believe that if one could put up with the kind of leadership Babu had in UON for that long, they might have changed right now, but time will tell. But that one is not my point of contention.
Yes.
What I'm saying is that NDA is the right thing, but it must be grounded on the perfect principles of politics.
Yes,
because we cannot simply go ourselves and say, oh, fine, you came from Baku, you know, now you pick our leader and choose for us leaders. You say the leaders were returned back because he valued democracy.
Yeah.
And these same individuals who are there, when students were being suspended in various universities, these same individuals who are there, they were doing several things. So I really feel afraid for that.
Let me say something.
Yes, yes.
You see, we don't have a problem with those who are camouflaging.
Yeah.
What do we do camouflage for a better purpose?
Uh-huh.
That's good. If you camouflage for a wrong purpose, then that is bad.
Okay, so you expect them to camouflage for the right purpose.
Yes, you know, what is not saying is that negative sign.
Okay.
So he's camouflaging for a better purpose.
Yes.
And again, the same thing he has taken.
So several
you believe
negative resolution is wise.
So much wise.
Okay. Thank you so much. We take another quick break, but we come back to end and bring this discussion tonight. Stay with us. TGIF show, and I am the host, Imada Barak, and joining us is the guy Kogo, former president of Kwan University, and Ahmed Moses, a political analyst and again a student at Kwan University, Stewart, a revolutionary and a committed MBF. Thank you so much for continuing staying with us. We're coming to the end of the show, our discussion again. Maybe we can round it off with the last statements from various from you, gentlemen. Start from a guy, you have 57 minutes.
Thank you. As in MDF,
yes.
Like I said before, it is not about us.
Yeah.
We believe that there is an elephant in the house. There's a leadership gap in this country. There's a problem we need to address. There's a problem we need to speak about. And I want to invite my friend here,
Ahmed Moses,
on his way, as we launch MDF officially so that he can get to understand better.
Yeah.
What do we stand for when we say we are championing for MDF? Mm. It is all about a social responsibility.
Okay.
As a Kenyan citizen, to speak for the rights, you demand for the rights because you are a taxpayer. We don't want to ignore this situation.
Okay. Man Moses, 7 seconds.
Well, what we have to admit is that our country is ripe for a revolution.
Yes.
We have a problem, And just the first step of solving the problem is admitting that there is one.
Yeah.
And I believe that MDF is the right call, and if well actuated, it will achieve much.
Yeah.
And therefore, for us to achieve, or for those who are of the MDF to achieve, MDF must be rooted on the right principles. They must be rooted on the right goals, and they must be rooted on based on the future aspiration of the common man. Thank you.
Okay, do you want to
second? Well, just to conclude and say that we believe that there is nothing for us without us. So, as liberal minds in Kenya, as those who are willing to fight injustice,
yes,
those who are willing to fight on behalf of the oppressed, we are going to come together. We are going to regroup, come together and fight. It's not going to be a physical war. We say we have our voices, we have our hearts, we have our brains, and we have our legs. We are going to march together. Imagine 1,000 youths, 2,000 youths marching in the streets of Nairobi, 4,000 youths marching in the streets of Kisumu under the umbrella of MDF, just fighting for a common purpose.
All right.
Let's achieve it.
Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you so much for having stayed with us. And we are coming to the last segment of this show, but this TGIF show. Thank God it's Friday. I am Austin Marlon Barak, and tonight we are ending in fun and games with Florence Maina. But tonight we have some few questions for you. Thank you so much for the serious part of MBF.
Yes.
Now it's a serious segment, so don't be tense, okay? One question: what can be broken that is never held?
What can be broken but it is never held?
Yeah. Any fast reaction? Trust. Trust? Okay. Those are your views. Thank you so much. What is that lives if it is fed, but dies if it is given away? What is that that lives if it is fed and dies if it is given a drink?
How about
wisdom?
Wisdom. Okay. What can one catch that is not thrown?
Opportunity,
yes. That is not thrown. What can we catch? What can one catch that is not thrown?
Wisdom.
I think you're done with the actual stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much. The first one was probably the second one, fire, and the last one is cold. Thank you so much for having joined us. We have come to the wrap up of the show, and I thank you so much for having stayed with us. I wish you a nice weekend. Until next time, goodbye.